boys. Hey, girls. Welcome to Louisiana Cajun Recipes. Today I'm going to make a Cubano sandwich. And they're very easy to make. And it's basically the same as making carnitas, where you're going to use pork. You're going to roast the pork. Pork butt is the choice. And being as I'm only going to make two sandwiches, I bought some of the country style ribs, which is cut from the pork butt. And I'm going to probably do two or one and a half of them, because they're pretty good size, and just freeze the rest. This does not freeze well after it's cooked. Pork and certain chicken dishes, they don't. Here's our basic ingredients: salt and pepper, chili powder, cumin, olive oil, onion, garlic, lemon, lime, cinnamon stick. And if you can't get Cubano bread, get some Bolio buns. They're kind of semi-sweet, like Cuban bread is. And this is simple. I mean, I got the meat in the fridge. I'm gonna go ahead and prep this stuff up, and it's just a little of this, a little of that. Google a recipe for carnitas. And if you don't have that blood orange marinade, I think it's called Mojo, you can make your own by just blending some lime and orange, and it's gonna taste almost exactly the same. You won't be able to tell the difference by the time you put all this other stuff on it. All right, we're gonna put some fresh cracked pepper, plenty of salt, some chili powder, some cumin. A little bit more salt, JB. Yeah, there's a cinnamon stick. There was a bay leaf went in right at first. Onion, garlic. And we got some fresh orange juice and lime juice. And I'm going to rinse these because they were cut on a bandsaw and there's bone in them. And you don't want to chew on the bone fragments. They get stuck in your teeth. So, leave the fat on them. That's going to help them when they cook. And you want to nestle them really tightly in the pan. Put the seasonings on them, and there's some oil. Use whatever kind of oil you want. You could even use, add a little bit more liquid too.
Now you could also do this in a roasting pan, or a bigger one, whatever you need. But like I said, I'm doing a small batch. So, just put it on the stove, let it cook till it's fork tender. And, you know, if you do it in the oven, you probably don't need to add any liquid to it, any water, in other words. But you do have to nestle the pork really tightly in a container. On a stovetop, it's a little different. So now we can goof off for a little bit. And while that cooks, it should probably take, an hour, 2 hours. We'll check it. Just simmer it on low until it's fork tender and ready to shred. Drop dead simple, stupid, easy to do. And build a sandwich. You get Swiss cheese, ham, or salami if you wish. That's optional. It's some places do it with salami, some don't. Just saying.
So I transferred it to a smaller pot so it would nestle a little better. And we're going to pull it out, separate the bones and the fat, and reserve some of the juice. There we're separating pieces, parts. And you see, it's just with the tongs, it just falls apart. You could have roasted it in the oven if you wanted to, but you don't have to. And what I'm going to do is add a little bit more of the liquid. Taste of some, and it's great. I put some mustard on there, on the Bolio, and I want mayonnaise. I just like mayonnaise, okay? If you want just mustard, just put mustard. Put your Swiss cheese on there. Put it on all four pieces, parts of the bread. Taste a little bit too, JB. Make sure it's good. I've seen you do that, see? Y'all probably didn't catch it, but I did it. There's some sliced, shaved ham. and some pickles. Put as many as you want. Put your pork on there, and there's my sandwich press. It's all hot, ready to go. The pork's on the bottom side, I think. It don't matter. Assemble. Put them in the press and press. Let them go. Now they're ready to eat. Oh, yum. So how was it? It was delicious. Fantastic, man. You need to try this. Give me a thumbs up. Subscribe if you like what you see.
And you could use that same recipe. I see the lights in your eyes. The glare from the overhead. That same basic recipe to make the filling for tamales. After you remove the beef, shred it up real fine. You discard the vegetables. You don't. Well, I may not. I'll probably add them to my sandwich, but they're probably going to cook to nothing. The cinnamon stick, you got to get it out. But in the bay leaf, naturally. It won't hurt you, just fiber. So is it fact or crap? It is fiber. Wood fiber, leaf fiber. So you got some glare, huh? Replacing the light fixtures, and I gotta paint the ceiling because where the light was, there's some holes up there where the fluorescent fixture was. So I'm getting ready to, I just got some temporary lighting up to prep for painting new floors, cabinets, and stuff like that. Doing some remodeling. How about that? It's gotta be pressed. That's the big thing about it. You know, if you don't have the right kind of bread, you could substitute, hoagie rolls or po' boy bread. But if you go by any Hispanic market, you should be able to find the bolios. I've even seen them at Walmart.
Yeah, so use your eyes and your brain app to build a taco tower. It's easy. My newest favorite food is birria en consomme. Mexican French dip, in other words. Oh, man, I made a video of it. Check it out. Deliciousness. A boy, a girl, a bye.